getting a license isn't just filling out a form and submitting it to the state. There's a lot of background that actually goes into it that respects your profession to say your colleagues trust you, that you are capable of performing a level of task to the public.
Typically, you're required to do continuing education courses and keep up on the latest technology, the laws and rules changes in your state, and there's just a venue there to keep the surveyor abreast of the latest technology and changes in the profession, whereas an unlicensed surveyor would, there's no way to track it. They may or may not. And so there's continually a method for the surveyor to better themselves and their knowledge as they continue their profession.
The licensure helps to maintain a certain standard across the board that engineers have met this standard and that it is an acceptable standard to be able to provide services for the public. An unlicensed engineer may do things that a licensed engineer may not do, may not feel that they have to be held to a certain standard, and that would be a travesty.
So when you hire somebody who's a professional, you have the ability to know that that person has the credentials, the knowledge, the skills through examinations that are given and that person has passed, through education that person has taken and passed, and also through that experience that they've had under a licensee. So that person can be confident that the person they're hiring has that background that they need and is not somebody who could eventually hurt them in a way.